In this tutorial, I'll show you how to integrate ImGui into your GLFW-based OpenGL project. If you don't know the basics of OpenGL or GLFW, I recommend watching my tutorials 0 through 2 of my OpenGL tutorial series, or reading the first tutorials from learnopengl.com by Joey DeVries. So let's start by downloading ImGui from its GitHub repository, which you can find the link to down in the description. Now open up your project folder and create a folder named ImGui. Open up the downloaded repo and extract the following files into the ImGui folder. Now, because we are using GLFW, we'll also have to go into the backends folder and extract these two files with GLFW in their name, and of course the OpenGL3 files as well. Now in Visual Studio, go to Project, Properties, C/C++, and General. In additional include directories, simply write ImGui or whatever the name of the folder in which you extracted everything is. Then add a new filter in your source files named ImGui and drag and drop all the CPP files in there. Now do the same for the header files. The last step of the integration is to include the following header files before GLFW and GLAD. Then to initialize it, we should check the version, create a context, create a variable to deal with inputs and outputs, choose our style, and then write these long-ass functions that take our GLFW window, true, and the version of GLSL we use. Since I am using OpenGL 3.3 in this tutorial, I need to use version 3.30 of GLSL. Keep in mind that you're not supposed to understand why we wrote all this stuff, you simply have to write this to set up ImGui. Now if you run the program, there should be no errors. If you do have errors, you might have just messed up somewhere along the road. If you have linking errors, you probably forgot to add the ImGui files inside Visual Studio. So let's add an actual UI window. To do that, we need to go into our main while loop, and right after we clear our OpenGL buffer, we want to declare a new frame using these three functions to sort of let ImGui know that we are working on a new frame right now. Then after that, you want to have all your OpenGL drawing stuff and input handling, and then after that, we'll create a UI window with the function begin, plugging in the name we want to give the window. Now we can simply add some text with a text function, and last but not least, finish up the window using the end function and render the UI elements with these two functions. Now before we run the program, we should end the ImGui processes at the end of our main function outside the main while loop using these functions. Now if you run the program, you should be able to see a little UI window present on your screen. It's useless though, so let's add some functionality to it. We can create a bool that dictates if we draw the triangle and then create a checkbox for the bool using the checkbox function, plugging in the name of the checkbox and the reference to the bool. We can also create a float named size, which we can multiply in our vertex shader to change the size of the triangle, and add a slider to it using the slider float function, giving it a name, a reference to the float, and its min and max values. Lastly, we can change the color of the triangle in the fragment shader and add an ImGui color editor using the function colorEdit4, giving it a name and the float array of our colors. Now, if you compile your program, the window should be there and all these functions should be working nicely. One last thing to note is that if you want your application to ignore your mouse inputs while hovering over an ImGui UI element, then just use an if statement dependent on not io.wantCaptureMouse, and which contains your input handling. That was it for this tutorial. If you want to know more about ImGui functionalities, just do a quick Google search or look in the imgui.h file. As always, the source code is in the description. Bye!